Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. So we got some exciting news this morning. The official trailer for the HBO adaptation of The Last of Us has finally dropped. I did not know this was coming. I was doing some reading of One Piece and I was on one of my many procrastination breaks and I just randomly found this on YouTube. And honestly, I was just going to scroll right past it because I didn't expect it to be very good. I haven't had very high hopes for any of the adaptations recently, because we've been having a lot of just poor adaptations. But I thought I'd give it a go, I thought I'd watch it, and I was actually very pleasantly surprised, but I do still have some concerns with it, so I just wanted to make a video, kind of talk about the things that I thought looked really good, the things that I'm still a little concerned about. But honestly, it's looking better than I was expecting. I think one of the big things that are going in its favor is that it's an adaptation by HBO. HBO has done some pretty good adaptations, such as Game of Thrones. You know, we all give it shit about the last two seasons, but before that it was pretty good. They also did a lot of, like, pretty graphically good war stuff, like they did Generation Kill. I'm pretty sure HBO did The Wire as well, which is considered one of the greatest shows ever. Plus, HBO's got a lot of money to put behind their projects. It's not like Netflix, where they're just kind of blanketing the market with, you know, subpar things just to get people to watch. HBO does have that time and money to put behind their projects. So it is giving me more hope for this. And I just wanted to touch on a couple of things, like the themes, you know, the storyline elements that you can see from it, the characters, the set pieces and locations, and just kind of talk about the good and the bad. Firstly, I'll start with the characterization because I'm really 50-50 with that one. When it came to Joel, when it came to when we first originally got to the release of who was playing who and the list of actors and actresses and their roles, I was not convinced. I was like, this is looking dreadful. But now that I've seen it in the trailer, I think the casting for Joel was actually pretty good. I think that guy, I don't know him. I don't think I've seen many movies that he's in. I know he's a famous actor, but I haven't seen much that he's in. I think that he's got that really weary, worldly look about him. Like, he looks like he's been through some shit. He looks like he's had a hard life, and I think that's, like, very suited for Joel. I don't know if that's what he actually looks like or if that's just his makeup, but I feel as if he's got the look for it, and I feel as if he's got that presence about him that does make him a good Joel. For Ellie, I wasn't convinced when we first got that casting choice for Ellie, and I'm still not overly convinced on Ellie, although we do see a point where she does, like, make a joke where she acts like she's turning into a clicker. You know, that did come off quite well. So I'm hoping that, you know, just because she doesn't look the part, that hopefully she does a great job. You know, like, I do want this to succeed. I don't want this to be bad. Besides Joel and Ellie, we don't really see many of the other main characters. We see Tess for a little bit. But besides her, we just kind of see some flashes of, you know, I think we see Tony at one point. We see the guy at the end, I don't want to say too much just in case people don't know what happens. And I believe we see the two brothers, or at least we hear them speak at one point. But one of the big things that really struck me, one of the big things that really, like, got my attention, I was like, oh wow, this is actually looking really good, is the set pieces and the locations that they're filming. You see, you know, down the street there'll be all the overgrown buildings all through, like, the ruins and that, or the, you know, when they're driving through the pine forest. It all looks very The Last of Us, and even how it transitions from, you know, spring to winter. All of the exteriors that we see are very much, you know, reminiscent of that The Last of Us playthrough that you do. Everything's, like, ruined and overgrown, and all of the insides are exactly the same as well. I thought they all looked very good. I thought it was all very nostalgic. When it comes to the themes and the tones displayed in the trailer, it all comes across as either very dark or very grand in nature, which is very fitting of The Last of Us, and it's exactly what you would want and expect from a good adaptation. Because that's exactly what the game was. It was dark, and it was, like, on a grand scale. It expanded from, I think it started in summer, and then it went, you know, summer, spring, winter. Sorry, summer, autumn, winter, and then it ends in spring, which I guess is symbolic now. I'm realizing that now. And the themes themselves are quite dark because you're dealing with, you know, a zombie apocalypse, you're dealing with the world has been destroyed, everything's just been bombed the hell to try and you know, get this infection under control. Everyone now lives in safe zones that are, you know, very strictly government controlled, like military controlled checkpoints. People are issued rations, and sometimes people aren't even issued rations. Everywhere's patrolled by the military, and places that aren't patrolled by the military are overrun by zombies or like cannibals and stuff. So all of the themes are quite dark. You know, there's cannibalistic. There's people that just want to kill you for the fun of it. There's people that want to kill you to take all your stuff. The government wants to kill you at all points, especially if you are seen just outside of the safe zones, because they're presuming that you're already infected, or they're just jerks, whatever. And the final point I want to touch on is like gameplay elements that we see and things that just make it seem like they're going to stick to the source material, right? Like when you're watching that trailer, you can already tell that they're not 100% sticking to the source material, but at the end of the day, they don't need to, right? Like, video games transition to TV or movies in a different way. Books transition to TVs and movies in a different way. It's not realistic to expect it to be a shot-for-shot remake. And also, as a fan of The Last of Us, I don't want it to be a shot-for-shot remake because, I mean, I already know that story. I already know what's around every corner. So if they do put in, you know, a new mission that Joel and Ellie have to go on and then everything's kind of new for me, you know, as long as it's still sticking to that theme and that spirit, there is no issue around that. But you do see a lot of, you know, recognizable moments from the video game, such as Bill, who I didn't mention earlier, but you see Bill and Bill brings up an interesting point, because at the end of that part with Bill, something very interesting happens, and I wonder if they will bring more light to that. Right, because if you know, you know, and they don't ever explicitly like come out and say, like, you know, but it'd be interesting to see if they did something more with that, because I mean, you know, now's the times that they do want to do more with that kind of stuff. So that would be really interesting to find out. I'm pretty sure that we also see, talking about Bill, we also see a location with the school. You know, we all remember what happens with the school and the whole plot points around that. We also at the end of the trailer see a part where Ellie's on a table and a cleaver comes down next to her head, right? And this fills me with joy, right? That plus the scene where you see everything is in snow, because it makes me feel as if, so obviously I've done no research into this because I kind of thought it was going to be a flop, but now I've seen it, I'm like, oh, actually, you know what? This actually looks pretty good. So from the trailer and from my knowledge of The Last of Us, from the scenes of the winter and from the scenes where Ellie is on that table and the cleaver comes down next to her head, it makes me feel as if this season, or you know, whatever, we are going to get the entire thing. We're not going to have to wait, and they're not going to drag it over four seasons that are going to be like summer, autumn, winter, spring, and then do it over four seasons. So it looks like they're going to give us the whole thing at once, just because they're showing us stuff that happens at the end of the series. And just to finish off this video, I just wanted to say that I think that the clickers, you know, I think that the zombies look really good. Right at the end of the trailer, you see that big one come up, you know, I guess is reminiscent of like certain points in the game where you have the boss fights. I think that the zombies look pretty good. You don't really get to see too much of them. I hope that that wasn't like a smoke and mirrors thing, because like they're just kind of terrible looking. So they're like, hey, we'll put everything in darkness and kind of, you know, behind windows and stuff so people don't see it because it's terrible CGI. I've got high hopes. I mean, it's HBO, like give us the budget, bruv. I mean, you know, they spent all this money CGIing dragons, CGI some clickers for us. And I think all the scenes with like the soldiers and the fireflies and the like marauders or bandits or whatever you call them, I think that all of those scenes give off that feeling of like, oh shit, like these people mean business, you know, whether they're like moving through tactically in the street or smashing through doors or they're driving past in their vehicles, like it all looks like real serious, like all three of those contingents look like bad people that will do bad things. Anyways, yeah, that's it. I just wanted to have a quick touch base. I just wanted to say that, you know, HBO, I hope that they're gonna do a great job. I've got higher hopes than when I first found out that they were doing a Last of Us, you know, TV series, because, you know, they haven't done justice to The Witcher. Like, I love The Witcher games, I love The Witcher books, and that Witcher TV show was just, it was like Henry Cavill was good, I think we can all agree on that, but the rest of it was just like, it was more Xena Warrior Princess. It was like tacky as all buggery. And I'm sure we can all think of a bunch more adaptations that just did not do it justice. But I've got high hopes for this one, so, you know, good luck HBO, I believe in you. Thanks for watching this far. If you have, feel free to like, subscribe, leave a comment, what do you think of it? See you in the next video, and as always, thank you very much.